Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to worship on this wonderful fall day at First Christian Church in Wilmington, Ohio. And we're so glad that so many of you have gathered in the sanctuary today for a special rite of Christian baptism. We are going to be so blessed today by being able to share in and participate in these young people's baptisms. It is a blessed day. And if you're watching us on Facebook Live or later on YouTube, we are so glad that you have joined us in worship also. Today is also a special day. Although he is not with us this morning, he's watching on Facebook Live. And so I think it is appropriate for us to say to our Minister Emeritus, Don Mertz, happy 80th birthday today. Would you join me in congratulating him? Happy birthday, Don, and many, many more. And we have a few cards for you that we will drop off a little bit later. My friends, it is time for us to enter into an attitude of worship, and I would ask that you join me in a word of prayer. We invite you to be present to us. We invite one another to be open to presence of the living God. We especially pray today for these young people who will be baptized. And we ask that their confessions of faith and that their time in the water might be strong memories they carry with them all the days of their life, and that this is a springboard into a rich and deep life of the Spirit. May each of us renew our baptism in this moment, so that we too might experience again what it is to like to walk in newness of life. It is for this and all these gifts we pray in thanksgiving. break? Okay, good. Today, I want to just talk to you real quickly about something the Bible says. How many hairs do you think are on your head? 1,000? That's a good guess.
2,392.
Thank you, Isaac, our local Bible scholar. I have no doubt that you're right. Suffice it to say that there's a lot of hairs on your head, right? And if you took every one of them and counted them, it might take a really, really long time.
My mom would.
Your mom would what?
Be mad.
What? Because you're counting them?
No.
Oh, no. No, I didn't mean to pull it out. No, we don't want to do that. Some of us will lose it fast enough anyway. But the Bible says that God knows every hair on your head. What do you think that means? That God knows every hair on your head. God knows all the details about you. Excellent. Why do I even bother? Yeah. That is such a good insight. That God knows everything about you. Not just the number of hairs on your head, but also the thoughts that you think, all of the wonderful things that you do, and sometimes the things that we don't do as well as we should. Sometimes God looks at us and says, oh, I wish you would be nicer to your sister or brother. Or sometimes God says, that was amazing. You did so well. I am so proud of you because I love you and I want you to love others in the same way. You know, this camera here, hey, everybody out there, do you know that there's people watching us right now on the internet and that they can see from different places what we're doing and talking about? Even more so, God sees what we're doing and talking about, and it pleases God so much that we are here in worship together, that we're singing the songs of praise, that we are working to love each other and to take care of one another. And today especially, God is super pleased that three of you will be baptized. That is an awesome thing that makes God smile. And I hope that you can understand that. So, be aware that God is watching you, not so that God can say, oh, you did bad, but so that God can say, you are my child, and I love you, and I know all these things about you so that I can help you grow and learn how to love and take care of others. I hope that's good news to you. So let's have a word of prayer together. Lord, we thank you for this day and your blessings. And we ask you to love us and care for us so that we can reach out and care for others. We know all kinds of things about each other. And we just hope that we can use that insight to help them as best we can. To your glory, in Jesus' name, amen. Thank you all. You can head back to your seats. Praise God with others when they are celebrating. celebrating what has been accomplished on their behalf. I would like, in the next few moments of silence, for you to take some time to reflect upon this list and to lift these individuals and their circumstances up to the Lord. So will you pray with me?
Clothing, shelter, and a bed to sleep in. God wants everyone to experience
authority for baptism comes from Jesus himself. In Matthew 28, 18 to 20, then Jesus came to them and said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age." Would you pray with me? Good and faithful God, we come before you as children in need of a parent, as those who desire to follow in the way that will bless us. And it is your Son, Jesus Christ, who says to his church, to his disciples, "Teach them and baptize them in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit." We seek to be faithful to your model of faithfulness to you, O Lord. And we desire to walk in this way. And so we come to confession of faith, which leads to baptism, which leads to the life eternal. As we come to the table of the Lord and are nourished for our discipleship, all this is connected. And we ask that upon these young people, that they may grow into a full life of faith and walk in the way of Jesus forever. For this we pray in Christ's name. Amen. So would you join me as we prepare for these baptisms? Thank you.
Thank you. John, tell me when my hour is up.
Oh.
I wanted to share with you and ask you about a program. We've got a program called Be the Light. Be the Light, Be the Molders of Dreams. And when I gave you that topic, I said, you know, accepting the directorship of the Christian Academy has been quite an adventure. And a couple of my teachers are here. They said, we're going to another sermon. It's particularly delightful for me to watch our students accept the Lord and walk forward. Share with you a little bit about my journey back and how we get where we're at. You know, about 3 years ago, I decided to come back and end 3 years of education. Consulting position that I had in a 3-year contract, and I wanted to come home to Wilmington, Flint County, and finish those 3 years. Well, this thing called COVID comes through in March, was it almost 2 years now, and takes away that 3-year contract. And suddenly you find yourselves in a situation where you say, God, what next? So like most people, you sit and you pout and you worry and you stew over what you're going to do next and you say, please lead me, please direct me. And then we pray. And you know, when we pray, we want answers immediately, like an ATM. And sometimes God says yes, sometimes he says no, but oftentimes he says wait. So wait, I did, sought counsel, and I have to tell you, our pastor here was one of those great influences during that time of indecision. But accepting a position to lead again was different. I was prepared, 38 plus years of being principal, school improvement coordinator, yada yada, but I'd never been a leader. And that took a lot of prayer, that took a lot of self-reflection about who I was and where I was going to be. I knew that I was prepared to do something, but not sure exactly what it was. Can you imagine this sort of Edmund Hillary when he scaled Mount Everest? They walked over and said, well, what were your plan to get there? He said, I don't know, just went out for a walk. We have to answer God's call. So you listen, and I think the older we get, the more we are in tune to listening to what God wants us to do. So it's been a great call. It's been a great challenge. It's been a great responsibility. I asked myself a question as I worded, why was he tugging at me? Was I equipped? Could I do the job? And then I happened to look one day, after accepting the role, I looked at my bookshelf, and I saw this book stand up. It's called Be the Light. It's not so much a scriptural devotional as it is a collection of passages from famous people, Mother Teresa, Nelson Mandela, the popes, quotes that they have used to inspire and to motivate. So I brought to the school the idea saying, why don't we have the children, 259 of them, and 33 staff members, why don't we develop the theme of Be the Light? And ironically, the message this morning is Be the Light. So throughout our building, as we make progress with this theme, you'll see scriptural passages about from Matthew 5, 3 through 10, and then 13 through 16. So Be the Light is something that we have embraced at the school. John 8, 12 through 20 talks about being in the world of darkness. I'm not sure that you realize how dark our world is. I think you do. Turn on the television. Terrorism. COVID. Everything in our world is dark. And it can be very about this, though. The professor walked in a suit and tie. He walked up in front of the class and he handed out the outline, but before he handed out the syllabus, he said, "Young gentlemen and young ladies, I'm Professor Dutterwich. This is Insurance 101. And he said, "I'll be teaching you about insurance," but he said, "I am a servant of the Lord Jesus Christ." And I stopped and thought, what? He said, "I am a servant of the Lord Jesus Christ. And although we'll talk about insurance, if any of you want to stop by my office sometime, let's talk about what's really important." Now, at 19, I'm not sure I got the significance of that, except that it's left an impact in my life. Here was a man that was not hiding his plan under a basket. He was shining his light on the hill so that everybody could see. And that takes a lot of courage. Now, you know, if you're sitting out there are people who wear Christianity, you don't have to ask them about their Christianity because they shine the light. And what I've said to our young people, and not so much to the staff, is, are you a matchlight? Are you a candle? Are you a flashlight? Or are you a floodlight? So our light in this world of darkness is so important. You know, when you read Matthew, and he begins discussion in chapter 5, 3 through 10, talks about the Sermon on the Mount and the Beatitudes. Well, what are the Beatitudes? The Beatitudes are simply a collection of thoughts about honesty, love, happiness, felicity, trust. That's what the Beatitudes were speaking about. So, I don't know how salty I am, but I know that salt preserves, the words be the salt of the earth, and I don't know how well each day we do this, but the light is important. The light is important. I asked you this morning, because I come from that field now, 40 plus years of education, pray for our teachers. Whether they're in a Christian environment, or the public schools, or private schools, our teachers are molders of dreams. And they have such an impact. These three that were baptized today, they will need guidance and love and support. And they'll need our molding of their dreams for their lives to be fulfilled. I'm sure sometimes with the COVID and the terrorism, storms, violence and the darkness and TikTok. There's a craziness going about the country where young people watching TikTok go into their schools and take their soap dispensers off the wall, dump the soap. Some even try to flush those down the toilet. That's called the devil's swirl. And I wasn't knowledgeable about it until one of our students told me. who are the molders of their dreams, the gods who build or crush the very young beliefs. You are the spark that sets aflame the poesy or lights the flame of some great singer's song. You are the gods of the young, the very young, and you are the guardian of a million dreams. Your every smile or your every frown can heal or pierce a heart. Yours are 100 lives, 1,000 lives. Yours the pride of loving them and the sorrow too. Your patient word, your touch, make you the gods of hope, who fill their souls with dreams to make those dreams come true. You see, we live in a different world, and you never know, quite frankly, where kids are coming from. Just when you think you know, you really don't. So it's important, those of us who work in education, and those of us here who are all teachers, to try to understand sometimes that you just never know where people are coming from. That's called shifting your paradigm, the way that you view things, the way that you do things. Let me close with just a word. Father God, we thank you for the blessings that you bestow upon us. Thank you, God, for this congregation. We thank you for the love, the commitment, the dedication of those who lead and those who belong. We ask you, God, to prick our hearts each day to be the light, to be the positive light. Not a matchbox, not a candlelight, not a flashlight. Rather, a floodlight. Let the work that we do glorify you in heaven. We ask all of this in your Son, Jesus' name.
My apologies if the power goes out on this.
Thy kingdom come.
it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever.
Preparation is on the back of your roll to gather us.
Thank you.
young people, but also in the lives of these young people, because we have all become young at heart in the Lord this day by what we have experienced and shared. You renewed your baptism today, and that is a gift of God to the people of God, and we are so grateful. At this point in time, I would like to invite all who would like to receive the Lord Jesus Christ into their heart for the first time to confess Him as Lord and Savior to come forward while we sing. If you would like to join us here in ministry by transfer of membership, that your gifts and our gifts together might glorify God, and come forward as we sing. And if you feel compelled to renew your heart in the Lord, come forward while we sing. And our invocation hymn is one that we all learned when we were very young, This Little Life of Mine. Would you stand as we sing? Not just as a written reminder, but as our commitment to you to help you grow in grace, to share your gifts, and for you to be bound together in the body of Christ with this people, so that we can glorify God together. May the Lord bless you. Frida Jenkins, who has been sharing worship life with us for a while, is here to place her membership in the life of the church. And so, Frida, we are so grateful. Frida Mae Jenkins. I want to get the whole thing in there. And so, Frida, we are just pleased that God has been speaking to you. And we are definitely pleased that the gifts He's placed in your life are going to be shared here among us. And together, all of us, Catherine, Greg, Frida, these kids, this congregation, can serve the Lord with gladness. And so I'm going to extend to you that same affirmation that you have received Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. You've received Him in your heart and choose to follow Him this day and always.
Absolutely.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord be with you all. And so I'm also going to invite our baptismal recipients to come forward now. We've got all kinds of things going on. All right, come on up here. Just look at this congregation that loves you so much. Don't you love them all? Lynn, I want to give you your certificate of baptism so that not only today, but many years from now, when you look at this, you'll remember this moment, that you'll remember you made that good confession of faith and that God loves you. Elizabeth, there is your certificate so that you remember the same. And Luke, so that you also remember God's love and mercy this day and forever. I am going to ask you once again to glorify God and let us know how you feel. So would you pray with me? And then I'm going to invite all of these to come out in the hallway with me so that you can welcome them and just love on them and let them know how exceedingly grateful you are for what God is doing in their lives. Would you pray with me? And now may the one who loves us beyond our ability to even imagine it so fill our hearts with love, so fill our words and our actions and attitudes with light, that all the darkness and despair and heartache is pushed back, and that all experience the good news that we are beloved, that these here today are beloved, that all God's people are beloved. And that is good news. And we pray it with thanksgiving in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.